The setting panel for the normalization and pre-processing is in the Setup Series tab in the lower panel. Adjust the height of the table by drag and drop. You can also zoom in vertically or horizontally with the buttons. In this case, it looks like above 100 is the signal range, and below 10 is the noise range. You can select a preset normalization scenario, RNA Seq count, to recall the normalize blocks. Clicking each block makes redraw the histogram. You can click on the triangle of each block to open the options panel. Please see how the block affects the datum. The boundary of noise and signal range lies between 10 and 100. By the default, it replaces values of less than 30 to 30. This block has the effect of limiting falsely detecting the differentially expressed genes in the noise range. Additionally, the next block fills up cells where the original count was zero or blanks. The default 4 means 2 to the power of 4 equals 16. The last block, centering, turns signals into ratio against the average. The processed signal is log-2 ratio against the average. This data set contains the control group and the treated groups by 3 SIRNAs. For such experimental design, the log-2 ratio against the control is more intuitive than the log-2 ratio against the average. Changing the reference of the ratio makes up or down regulated genes appear obviously. Let's get back to the scatter plot measurement view and change the vertical axis representing the processed signals. Above 0 indicates up-regulation, and below 0 does down against the control samples. You can examine the effect of the low signal cutoff block. If you set as 1, the processed signals in the noise range widely scatter. If you set the cutoff as 100, you seem to miss many truly varying genes. The risk of having false positives and that of false negatives is in the trade-off. You have to adjust the cutoff as viewing the actual data adequately.